Dear students, in an electric current chapter, in a last video, we learn combination of cells. In a combination of cell, in detail, I did one derivation for cells in series. Dear student, cells in series, by considering two cells, they connected in series, what happens to effective or equivalent value of EMF as well as effective and equivalent value of internal resistance, that we learn. Dear student, it is one of the important question for annual exam. Usually they are going to ask this question for 5 marks. Continuation of this, in case of combination of cells, there are two types of combination. One is called cells in series or series combination, that we already learned in last video. Second one is called parallel combination. And again, in case of series combination, I already told there will be a two important result or condition for series combination. What are the condition means? In case of series combination, current flowing through each cell is same. Pratyondu cell alli same current flow aagta irutte. Second condition is potential drop across each cell is different. ಅಂದರೆ ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ಸೆಲ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡುವ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಪೊಟೆನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಎನರ್ಜಿ, ಪೊಟೆನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಡ್ರಾಪ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದು. ನೆನ್ಪಿಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಸೀರೀಸ್ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ಸೆಲ್ಲಲ್ಲಿ ಫ್ಲೋ ಆಗ್ತಿರುವ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಏನು ಕೇಳಿದರೆ, ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ ಏನಂತ ಕೇಳಿದರೆ, ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ಸೆಲ್ ನಡುವೆ ಡ್ರಾಪ್ ಆಗುವ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಷಿಯಲ್, ವಿ ಸೇ ದಟ್ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಡ್ರಾಪ್ ಅಕ್ರಾಸ್ ಈಚ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೀರೀಸ್ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್. But in case of parallel combination, we say that cells are connected in parallel. Here the word parallel combination means in between two common point, large numbers of components are connected. Component may be resistor, component may be capacitor, component may be cell, or it may be an inductor. You already learn about resistors in series, resistor in parallel, or capacitor in series, capacitor in parallel. ನೆನ್ಪಿಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಪ್ಯಾರಲಲ್ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಎರಡು ಕಾಮನ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ನಡುವೆ ದೇ ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾಂಪನೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಯಾವ ಕಾಂಪನೆಂಟು ಆಗ್ಬೋದು? ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನಿಕ್ ಕಾಂಪನೆಂಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟರ್, ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟರ್, ಸೆಲ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಟೂ ಕಾಂಪನೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಟೂ ಕಾಮನ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್, ದಟ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಪ್ಯಾರಲಲ್ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್. And again, in case of parallel combination, there are two important results or conditions are there. Two important result or condition. First result or first condition in case of parallel combination is potential drop. Potential drop across each cell. Across each cell is same. Keep this point in your mind. First condition is potential drop across each cell is same. And second important condition in case of parallel combination, current flowing through each cell is different. Current flowing through each cell is different. That means main current is equal to algebraic sum of current flowing through each cell. Main current is equal to algebraic sum of current flowing through each cell. Dear student, in case of parallel combination, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಎರಡು ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ ಅಥವಾ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಇದೆ. ಏನು ಕೇಳಿದರೆ, ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಡ್ರಾಪ್ ಅಕ್ರಾಸ್ ಈಚ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೇಮ್. ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ಸೆಲ್ ನಡುವೆ ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗ್ತಿರುವ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಸೇಮ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಅಂದರೆ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಷಿಯಲ್, ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಸ್ಪೆಂಡ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದರೆ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಡ್ರಾಪ್. ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್, ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಫ್ಲೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಈಚ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್. Potential is same, current flowing through each cell is different. The main current is equal to algebraic sum of current flowing through each cell. That becomes I1 plus I2 plus I3, so on, where I1, I2, I3 are called branch currents. I1, I2, I3 are called branch current. And again here, if I consider two points, imagine madkoli eradu point tagoltane, one point is A. I connected one cell like this, and the point is B. Where A and B are the two common points, in between A and B, we connect one more cell like this. We connect one more cell like this. Total how many cells are connected in between A and B? Three cells. Listen clearly. In between A and B are considered as two common points. In between two common points A and B, three cells are connected. Its EMF is E1, E2, E3. Internal resistance is R1, R2 and R3. Dear student, you already know the meaning of EMF. EMF is nothing but potential drop between two terminals of an electrode when there is no flow of current or current drawn is zero. And internal resistance is nothing but opposition offered by the cell itself for the flow of charge or current by considering electrolytic solution present in the cell. Ille more cell, EMF is E1, E2, E3, internal resistance R1, R2, R3 are connected in parallel between two common points A and B. It not compulsory that you have to connect only three cells. You may connect any number of cells, n number of cells. E case only, first cell provide a current is I1, second cell provide a current is I2, third cell provide a current is I3. Current flowing through each cell is different. Current flowing through each cell is different. But potential drop across each cell, E point naduve, potential drop enagirutte kelidre same agirutte. Each cell potential drop is same. Current flowing through each cell is different. And these three current combined together, I will get the main current. And this particular point is act like a junction. Junction in antelidre, it is a point where more than two lines will join. Usually new bus stand ke junction anta karithare ante enskoli. Alli erdukkinta jaasti road bandu join agirutte, it is called junction. Just imagine is a point where more than two lines are joined. Illi mooru line bandu join agide, ondu line horagade bandide. And mooru current illi bandu join agutte, it come out as I. I is the main current. That main current is equal to algebraic sum of current I1, I2 and I3, so on. This condition, keep one point clear in your mind. If we consider any one cell, it got a EMF is E, internal resistance is R. And when it is connected to an external circuit, imagine madkoli, external circuit ke connect agidante imagine madkoli, automatically this cell provide the energy. For external circuit, how much energy it will provide, just imagine idan resistance R anta tokondre, ee resistor na overcome madbekadre I want to spend the energy, that we call it as potential. This cell for external resistor or for external circuit, yes to energy kodate kelidre, V is equal to E minus IRS to energy. Illi E is the energy of the cell itself, total energy of the cell itself. One cell anna niv angadinda purchase madi tokombandre, adara value 1.5 volt idre, EMF is 1.5 volt. Adana niv clock atho remote use madidre, is it possible to get exactly 1.5 volt for clock? Is it possible to get exactly 1.5 volt for remote? No. And small amount of energy used by the cell itself because of its internal resistance. A small amount of energy cell use madatte, that energy we call it as IR. IR is the energy used by the cell itself because of its internal resistance. Automatically potential given by the cell for external purpose, horagade purpose ige, bere per component ige, atho external circuit ige, cell eshtu energy kodutte kelidre, E minus IR ashtu. energy given by a cell for external purpose is V is equal to E minus IR. Keep this point in your mind. Where V is called terminal potential difference. I already explained. A terminal potential difference V may be equal to E agiratte. If it is an ideal cell. Ideal cell tokondra internal resistance iralla. That I already explained. V is equal to E I to terminal potential difference itself is EMF. Practically it is difficult to get the ideal cell. Ideal cell is ikkodu kashta. Internal resistance zero anta helodu tumba kashta. There will be small internal resistance. Automatically outside purpose ge use madlikke cell estu energy kodutte kelidre V is equal to E minus IR. ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ವೇ ನೆನ್ಪಿಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ನಾನು ಸೆಲ್ ಅಂತ ಆದರೆ ನನ್ನ ಹತ್ರ 100 rupees ಇದೆ, ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಇಸ್ 100, ನನಗೆ ಡೈಲಿ ಖರ್ಚಿಗಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಂಡು 80 rupees ಬೇಕು, 80 rupees ಐ ನೀಡ್, 80 rupees ಐ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್. ಆಟೋಮೆಟಿಕಲಿ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಇನ್ ಮೈ ಬಾಡಿ ಈಸ್ 100 rupees. ಐ ಸೆಡ್ 100, ನಾನು ಇಷ್ಟು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೇನೆ, ನನಗೆ ಬೇಕಾಗಿರೋದು ಎಷ್ಟು 80 rupees. And yaradu bandu nanatra amount kelidre, if anyone going to ask money with me, is it possible for me to give completely 100 rupees to that person? No, I need 80 rupees for my daily wages. Automatically my limit is I can provide 20 rupees to him, because 80 rupees is my requirement, 20 rupees extra is there that I can give. Same way ಸೆಲ್ ಇನ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಏನಿರುತ್ತೆ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಎನರ್ಜಿಯನ್ನ ಸೆಲ್ಲೇ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಲೈಟ್. ಅದನ್ನು ಇಂಟರ್ನಲ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೆಯೋದು. ಉಳಿದ ಎನರ್ಜಿಯನ್ನು ಇಟ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಪ್ರೊವೈಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟರ್ನಲ್ ಪರ್ಪಸ್. ಕ್ಲಾಕ್ ತಿರುಗಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡೋ ಎನರ್ಜಿ, ರಿಮೋಟ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ಆಗಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡೋ ಎನರ್ಜಿ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಿ. ಎಷ್ಟು ವಿ ಇದೆ ಕೇಳಿದರೆ, ಇ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಸೆಲ್ ಮೈನಸ್ I into R, energy spent to overcome the internal resistance of cell itself. V is equal to E minus IR. Idana simplify madidre, IR is equal to IR taken to this side, E minus V agatte. Automatically from thus I can say I is equal to E minus V divided by R is the current given by the cell. It is a current drawn from this cell. Keep one point clear in your mind. If there is no internal resistance, automatically I can say complete energy baratta. Remember, current drawn from the cell I is equal to E minus V divided by R astagiratta. E minus V divided by R is the current drawn from the cell for external purpose. Is that clear? By considering this, we'll do the continuation of this concept. Dear student, after learning what is the meaning of parallel combination of cell, what are the condition in case of parallel combination of cell, we'll do the continuation of this. And next important thing is expression for effective or equivalent value of EMF and internal resistance of cell during which combination? Parallel combination. Dear student, only either they may ask, like if two cells are connected in parallel or three cells are connected in parallel, it may be any number of cell, method is same. Here they ask expression for effective or equivalent value of EMF and internal resistance of a cell during which combination? Parallel combination. Dear student, this one is one of the important question for 5 marks. They ask maximum time this question in exam. It is one of the important question for exam, mainly for 5 marks. In a parallel combination, I already said current flowing through each cell is different, potential drop across each cell is same. Here I consider 2 points. One is A. They connected one cell, first cell, its EMF is E1, internal resistance is R1. It is connected to one more cell, EMF is E2, internal resistance is R2. Both are connected like this. In between a common point A and B. In between two common point A and B, two cells of EMF E1 and E2, internal resistance R1 and R2 are connected. And from the cell 1, current drawn is I1,
From this cell 2, current drawn is I2 and I is the main current.
I is the main current. It is a given circuit. And from the cell 1, current is I1. From the cell 2, current is I2 and I is the main current, like this circuit. And again, I already said in a parallel combination, current flowing through each cell is different. Potential drop across each cell is same. In between these two cells, potential is same because they are connected in parallel. During parallel combination, current is different, potential is same. Potential is V itself. In general, I already said E1 and E2 are the EMF of the cell. EMF of the cell. R1 and R2 be the internal resistance. Internal resistance. Internal resistance. Again, in place of these two cells, I consider one single cell. I consider single cell between A and B. In place of these two cells, I consider one single cell between A and B. And whatever role played by these two cells together, same role played by a single cell. ಇದು ಎರಡು ಒಟ್ಟಾಗಿ ಏನು ಇಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ, ಸೇಮ್ ಇಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ದಿಸ್ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಾಟ್ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಗೋಟ್ ಇ ಎಮ್ ಎಫ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟಸ್ ಇ ಇಫೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ವಿಕ್ವಲ್ ಟಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇಫೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಫ್ಲೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಐ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಈಸ್ ವಿ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಈಸ್ ವಿ ದಿಸ್ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯೂಟ್ ವಿಕ್ವಲ್ ಟಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲೆಂಟ್ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯೂಟ್ This circuit we call it as equivalent circuit. Our requirement is expression for E effective, expression for R effective by using these two circuits. Dear student, I already said for cell, potential difference V is equal to EMF minus I into R that I already explained. How much energy it will provide for external purpose means EMF minus I into R. EMF is the energy of cell itself. I into R is the energy spent to overcome the internal resistance. Automatically from this we got I is equal to, I already provide this equation. I is equal to E minus V divided by R is a formula for current. Dear student, in a parallel combination, I already said current flowing through each cell is different. Potential is same. EMF is different. Internal resistance is different. Automatically, for cell of EMF E1, cell of EMF E1 or cell 1, current is I1, for cell 1, current is I1, EMF is E1, minus potential is same, because they are connected in parallel, divided by internal resistance is R1. I call this as equation number 1. Similarly, for cell of EMF E2, that is nothing but cell 2, current flowing through cell 2 is I2, EMF of cell 2 is E2, minus potential drop across cell 2 is V, because they are connected in parallel, V itself, divided by internal resistance of cell 2 is R2. I got current I2. Equation 2. For parallel combination, main current I is equal to algebraic sum of
current flowing through each cell, it becomes I1 plus I2 if it is a 2 cell, I1 plus I2 plus I3 if it is a 3 cell, I1 plus I2 plus I3 up to IN if it is a N number of cells. From 1 and equation 2, I is equal to, it is a main current, I1 is nothing but E1 minus V divided by R1 plus E2 minus V divided by R2. E1 minus V divided by R1 is I1 from equation 1. E2 minus V divided by R2 is equation 2. It is a formula for I2. That becomes I is equal to E1 divided by R1 minus V by R1 plus E2 divided by R2 minus V divided by R2. Again, that becomes I is equal to, I will take positive term together, negative term together. It becomes E1 divided by R1 plus E2 divided by R2. I consider together E1 by R1 plus E2 by R2 minus I consider V outside. V is common, minus is also common, taken outside. Inside a bracket remaining is 1 by R1, 1 by R2. It becomes 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. I call this as equation number 3. Next important thing, for an equivalent circuit, that is nothing but this one. For an equivalent circuit, this one, in place of these two cell, I introduce a single cell. ಇದು ಎರಡು ಸೆಲ್ ಒಟ್ಟಾಗಿ ಏನು ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ, ಅದೇ ಕೆಲಸವನ್ನು ಒಂದು ಸೆಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ದಾಟ್ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲೆಂಟ್ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯೂಟ್ ಸೆಲ್, ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಇಫೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ EMF ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ಇಫೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್. ಇದು ಎರಡರ EMF ಒಟ್ಟು ಒಂದು EMFಗೆ ಈಕ್ವಲ್, ಇದು ಎರಡರ ಇಂಟರ್ನಲ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಒಟ್ಟಾಗಿ ಒಂದು ಇಂಟರ್ನಲ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ಗೆ ಈಕ್ವಲ್. ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಫ್ಲೋ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ, ಐ, ಪೊಟೆನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಎಷ್ಟು, ವಿ. ಫಾರ್ ಅನ್ ಈಕ್ವಲೆಂಟ್ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯೂಟ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಐ, ಬೈ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ದಸ್ ಈಕ್ವೇಶನ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಐ, EMF ಈಸ್ ಇ ಇಫೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ದಟ್ ಐ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಗಿವನ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಈಸ್ ವಿ ಇಟ್ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಇಂಟರ್ನಲ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಈಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇಫೆಕ್ಟಿವ್. That we can write it as I is equal to E effective divided by R effective minus V divided by R effective. I call this one as equation number 4. Now, I got equation 3. I is equal to E1 by R1 plus E2 by R2 minus V into 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2, equation 3. I got equation 4. I is equal to E effective divided by R effective minus V divided by R effective, equation 4 for equivalent circuit. Both these two are equivalent to main current itself. Can I compare equation 3 and 4? Yes. Compare equation 3 and 4. We get E effective divided by R effective minus V divided by R effective is equal to E1 by R1 plus E2 divided by R2 one set minus V into 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. Can I compare LHS with RHS? Yes. When you want to compare this, after comparison we got E effective divided by R effective is equivalent to E1 by R1 plus E2 divided by R2. One formula I got. E effective divided by R effective is equal to E1 by R1 plus E2 by R2. Again, second formula, V is common. Minus and minus, same. ಎರಡನ್ನು ಕಂಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಐ ಗಾಟ್ 1 ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಆರ್ ಇಫೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 1 ಬೈ ಆರ್ 1 ಪ್ಲಸ್ 1 ಬೈ ಆರ್ 2. ದೀಸ್ ಟು ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ಐ ಗಾಟ್
for effective value of EMF and internal resistance, effective value of internal resistance during which combination? Parallel combination. Next step is
1 by R effective is equal to
1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 is there.
That I write it as R1 plus R2 divided by R1 into R2.
Simple math. After simplifying this, 1 by R effective is equal to R1 plus R2 divided by R1 into R2.
That is, R effective is equal to R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. I got the formula for effective value of internal resistance.
Then this equation E effective divided by R effective is equal to E1 by R1 plus E2 by R2.
That we can write it as E effective divided by R effective is equal to
E1 by R1 plus E2 by R2 becomes
E1 R2 plus E2 R1 divided by E1 R2 plus E2 R1 divided by R1 into R2. After simplification, E effective is equal to E1 R2 plus E2 R1 divided by R1 into R2 whole multiply into R effective.
That is nothing but this one is taken to this side.
That is E effective is equal to E1 R2 plus E2 R1 divided by R1 into R2.
What is the formula for R effective you already got?
R1 into R2 divided by R1 plus R2.
Simplify this. R1 into R2, R1 into R2 gets cancelled.
Effective value of EMF is equal to E1 R2 plus E2 R1 divided by R1 plus R2 is a formula for effective EMF.
Dear student, this question is like this. Obtain an expression for effective EMF and effective internal resistance of a cell when they are connected in which combination? Parallel combination. Effective EMF of a cell becomes E1 R2 plus E2 R1 divided by R1 plus R2. Effective internal resistance becomes R1 into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Dear student, these two are the important thing mainly for exam. This question they're going to ask mainly for exam for 5 marks. Dear student, in case of combination of cell, we learn two types of combination.
One is called series combination. Series combination of cell.
In a series combination of cell, current flowing through each cell is same, potential difference across each cell is different.
Automatically we got effective value of EMF is equal to E1 plus E2 for two cells we got. R effective is equal to R1 plus R2. This equation we got.
Here, point number A, if N cells are connected, then we got E effective is equal to E1 plus E2 plus so on up to EN. This equation also you got.
And similarly, R effective is equal to R1 plus R2 plus so on up to RN.
This one is for effective value of EMF and effective value of internal resistance. And these two things we learn in case of series combination. If two cells are connected in series, effective value of EMF becomes E1 plus E2. Effective value of internal resistance becomes R1 plus R2.
Ill hegide kelidre, two cells are connected like this in a same order.
They connected in same order.
Second thing, if they connected in reverse order, if two cells are connected in reverse order. That is like this. One cell, another cell, both are connected in reverse order. Automatically, effective value of EMF becomes E1 minus E2,
or it may be E2 minus E1, depending on which cell got more EMF. One way, E1 jasti idre E1 minus E2. E2 jasti idre E2 minus E1.
And there is no change in the internal resistance. R effective is equal to R1 plus R2 itself is one of the important result for competitive exam.
And next important thing, if I say that n number of identical cells
in series,
if n number of identical cells are connected in series, then effective value of EMF becomes E plus, so on up to E. Because all cells are identical, each cell got EMF is E, each cell got internal resistance is equal to R.
Automatically, effective value of EMF becomes N into E. This is the formula.
N into E. Similar to that, effective value of internal resistance becomes, all are identical means R. It becomes R plus R, so on.
Answer becomes N into R. Remember, if N number of identical cells, when they are connected in series, each cell got same EMF, each cell got same internal resistance,
effective value of EMF becomes N into E. Effective value of internal resistance becomes N into R.
From this, we get the current is equal to effective value of EMF divided by external resistance plus effective value of internal resistance.
During which combination? Series combination. Where R is the external resistor, where series combination of cell connected. Where series combination of cell is connected.
It should be like this. If I consider two cells and is connected to external resistor like this, it is R, current is I, it is E1, it is R1, it is E2, it got internal resistance is R2.
Automatically, either effective value of EMF becomes E effective, effective value of internal resistance becomes R effective. Automatically, current drawn from the combination is E effective divided by R plus R effective.
That I is equal to effective value of EMF is E1 plus E2, if it is identical, we can write as NE divided by R plus
effective value of internal resistance is N into R.
If N number of identical cells are connected,
ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ಎರಡೇ ಸೆಲ್ ತಗೊಂಡಿದ್ದೇನೆ, ಬಟ್ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಇರಬೇಕಂತೇನಿಲ್ಲ. N number of identical cells when they connected in series, automatically effective value of EMF becomes NE, effective value of internal resistance becomes NR. Automatically current drawn from system is NE divided by R plus NR. For which combination? For series combination. Is that clear? Right. Again, next important type of combination we call it as which combination? Second type of combination?
Parallel combination
of cell. In case of parallel combination of cell, effective value of EMF divided by R effective internal resistance is equal to E1 by R1 plus E2 by R2 plus so on up to En divided by Rn if n number of cells are connected in parallel.
If n number of cells are connected in parallel, this is the formula.
And again, for internal resistance, it becomes 1 divided by R effective is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus so on up to 1 divided by Rn if n number of cells are connected in parallel.
Here E1, E2 up to En are the EMF, R1, R2 up to Rn are the internal resistance.
Remember, for two cells, we got E effective divided by R effective is equal to E1 by R1 plus E2 by
R2. Similarly, 1 by R effective is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. Remember, here we got the two formula that I already did in this video itself. Effective value of EMF is equal to E1 R2 plus E2 R1 divided by R1 plus R2. It is a value for effective value of EMF. Similar to that, effective value of internal resistance becomes R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. These two formula you learn. And continuation of this, if I say that two cells are identical, identical and the same. If two cells are identical, automatically effective value of EMF becomes, two cells are identical, that you already learn clearly, EMF same iratte, internal resistance same iratte, that becomes ER plus ER divided by R plus R. That becomes effective value of EMF is equal to ER plus ER 2 times ER divided by R plus R 2R. Illi 2R and 2R gets cancelled. Automatically, effective value of EMF itself is equal to E, EMF of any one cell. Dear student, is one of the important result. One vele yeradu identical cell, same cell anna parallel agi connect maadidre automatically effective value of EMF becomes EMF of any one cell itself. Yenagutte external internal resistance yenagutte, we'll check that. R effective is equal to, both the cell are identical, R into R divided by R plus R. It becomes R effective is equal to R square divided by 2R. In other words, R effective is equal to R divided by 2. Internal resistance becomes half. ಇದನ್ನು ನೆನಪಿಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಎರಡು ಐಡೆಂಟಿಕಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಅನ್ನು ಪ್ಯಾರಲಲ್ ಆಗಿ ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಇಫೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ EMF becomes EMF ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸೆಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್, EMF ಆಫ್ ಎನಿ ಒನ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್. ಇಂಟರ್ನಲ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಟು ಹಾಫ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಥಿಂಗ್, ಇಫ್ ಎನ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಕಲ್, ಇಫ್ ಎನ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಕಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್, ಐಡೆಂಟಿಕಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ connected in parallel. If n number of identical cells are connected in parallel, automatically effective value of EMF again is equal to EMF of cell itself. ಎರಡು ಸೆಲ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಕಲ್, ಹತ್ತು ಸೆಲ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಅಥವಾ ನೂರು ಸೆಲ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ, ಆರ್ ಎನ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಕಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಪ್ಯಾರಲಲ್, ಇಫೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ EMF becomes EMF ಆಫ್ ಎನಿ ಒನ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಇಟ್ಸೆಲ್ಫ್. EMF ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು E ಇಟ್ಸೆಲ್ಫ್. ಇಂಟರ್ನಲ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇಫೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಎನ್, ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. R divided by N. Two identical cells are connected in parallel, R effective becomes R by 2, two cells. Three cells to kondre, R by 3. N cell to kondre, R by N. These two are the important result. ಇದನ್ನು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಇಫ್ ಎನ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಕಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಪ್ಯಾರಲಲ್, ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಡ್ರಾನ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಈಸ್ effective value of EMF divided by external resistance plus effective value of internal resistance, that I becomes EMF of cell itself. If n number of identical cells connected in parallel, effective value of EMF is EMF of any one cell itself. ಏನು ಚೇಂಜ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ, 1 volt 1 volt 1 volt 1 volt, 50 cell ಅನ್ನು ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಯಾವ ತರ ಪ್ಯಾರಲಲ್ ಆಗಿ, ಇಫೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ EMF ಈಸ್ 1 volt itself. Divided by external resistance plus internal resistance becomes R by N. Internal resistance becomes R by N. In other words, I is equal to EMF divided by NR plus R divided by N. Simplify madadaga, main current becomes EMF, N comes over here, NE divided by NR plus small r. Is the formula for main current if n number of identical cells are connected in parallel. ಈ ಎಲ್ಲ ರಿಸಲ್ಟನ್ನು ನೆನ್ಪಿಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ ಮೈನ್ಲಿ ಫಾರ್ ಕಾಂಪಿಟೇಟಿವ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ಸ್. ಇಸ್ ದಟ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್? ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು. ರಿಮೈನಿಂಗ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ವಿಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಇನ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್.